You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Linda, your host, and I'm happy to have back Lynn Smith, who's been a fan favorite on Greater Brockton. How are you?
Good, and I think this is our first get-together since the new year, so happy new year.
It is, yeah. We're back in business. We're heading up towards 500 episodes of this Greater Brockton.
Good job.
You're not 500, but you're close.
Thank you. Some days I feel 500.
No. So you are, once again, doing a wonderful community effort. Team Brockton Resident Leader Program. You've done this before a couple of times, and tell us about the new series.
Well, you know, basically what happened is people are aware that I volunteer with the Keith Park Neighborhood Association, and we had some success with the fountain in the park, and I also volunteer with the Frederick Douglass Neighborhood Association, and we had some success with the downtown community garden. So a research company came into the city to try to sort of help with community engagement and said, we like this idea in neighborhood associations. Can you see if you can grow that program? So last year I gave the first series of six training sessions and we got two new neighborhood associations out of it. So this is series number two of the training and we call it Team Brockton RLP, Resident Leader Program. You know, a lot of folks want to create connections in their community and on their street and in their neighborhood, but they just need a little practical advice on how to get going.
Well, if you look around the city, there are certain areas geographically that have been together. There were certain groups that lived in certain sections of the city, like the Lithuanian Village at the time. Brockton now is very mixed. There isn't an Italian section and a Jewish section and an African-American section. It's kind of nice because everybody's mixed together.
Exactly.
Which is what Brockton's always been, if you really think about it.
Right.
But there are, I was researching a little bit myself. I live Stoughton East in Brockton Line, which is called Brockton Heights. But when I found out how big Brockton Heights was, I got to narrow it down a little bit. So there's a Hancock Park, which doesn't have an association yet. I know I've talked to you about that. But in Ward 1, we kind of keep to ourselves and we don't do a lot of neighborhood stuff. That Hancock Park at one point was adopted by a Boy Scout and they built the bandstand that's over there and it kind of fell apart. Now it's being rebuilt. The city's done some nice landscaping to the park. We have the Audubon property over there. This is to actually create associations and get people into leadership. Who knows? They might run for office or get asked to be appointed to a city board or commission.
Right, and I mean, I think the thing is, some of our neighborhood associations have chosen a park to be their town green, but others have just chosen a street or a block. You know, there's a famous saying, Mahatma Gandhi, be the change you want to see in the world. Well, you know what? The world is too big for me. Sorry, can't do it.
Right.
But I can do my street.
Right.
And so what we're saying is most of our streets in Brockton are pretty diverse and pretty representative of our population. How about just getting four or five or six or ten people together that live in the same area and say, can we learn how to speak as one voice to city government about what concerns us, about what we'd like to see our neighborhood look like, and maybe have a few events to get people out of their houses, off their front porches, to meet each other. You know, I've been to a couple of the ward meetings, for example, and I've talked about this program. The training starts February 7th. It's at East Library. It's free. It's six classes, though. You have to go to all six classes. But one of the things I do at the ward meeting before I speak is I say to everybody, you know, we're usually in a cafeteria in the school on those little mushroom seats.
Yeah.
And, oh, boy, those are painful.
Yes.
And I say to people, get up. Stand up, stretch, look around, find a face of someone that you don't know, and introduce yourself.
Right.
You're all from this ward. Get to know each other. So a lot of the techniques that we use in this training are getting to know about leadership skills, getting to know how to identify skills that each person can bring to the table. One person might be good with graphics. One person might be good with a spreadsheet. One person might be good with creative ideas. We figure out a way to write operating principles. We figure out a way to get a tax ID, not to be a nonprofit, but just to open a bank account.
Right.
So that if anyone wants to give us a donation, you have the basic structure of your organization so that you can then pick a project or pick an event and work as a team towards it, speak to the city in one voice, figure out who's who in City Hall, who does what. Is that DPW? Is it highway? Is it ordinance? You know, who's responsible for the pieces of the puzzle that we need to get our project done?
I got the five signs, so we already went through four, which is good. The thing I like about this is it's so organized, okay? Talk about leadership and group dynamics, operating principles, forming a core group, funding, code of conduct. That's something in this day and age that everybody needs to
subscribe
to.
Well, people don't know that when you form a neighborhood association like that, and when you are kind of loosely representing your neighborhood, you are under the same code of conduct as an elected official would be. You have to make sure that you're careful about money, you're careful about contributions, you're careful that you don't slander someone. There are certain ways we need to treat each other as human beings in terms of respecting differences and celebrating our unique abilities, so we go through all of that. We also talk about liability. You know, what happens if you have an Easter egg hunt in one of the parks and one of the kids breaks an arm or breaks a leg? Mm-hmm. We also talk about how do we craft a letter to ask for support in a way that's effective. So you don't want to just hit people up, you know, every time you go to a cocktail party, hey, hey, hey. Right. You want to be able to tell a story. It's the storytelling that then will have somebody say, you know what, I like what you're doing. I'd like to give you $25 or $35 to help you out. You know, with the tax changes, 501c3 for small organizations right. isn't a big deal anymore.
Right.
And for small dollar donations, the idea is, how can I tell my story so that people say, I like what you're doing and I want to support you?
So six Thursday evenings, you have to go to all six. That's been my problem all along, because the city committee meets for the two of those
right.
in the time frame. They start on February 7th and on June 6th. They're consecutive, 6:30 to 7:45, which is not a long time. So if you get home, if you're coming home from Boston, you might still be able to grab a bite to eat. I know, Lynn, that you always tend to do food sometimes with different things
yep.
that you do. And I just think this helps, because there really isn't an instruction manual or a training manual to get active and get involved. Back in the day when I was a teenager, there was a League of Women Voters in Brockton, mm-hmm. and they worked to get people involved politically and civically.
Mm-hmm.
Civics and civic education has gone by the wayside. Luckily, the state's put it back in. This is a way to do it, and it's easy, and it doesn't cost anything.
People, it costs you your time.
Your time.
And also, people who know me know we start on time. 6:30 means 6:30, and we end on time because I want to be respectful of my librarians who have worked all day, and they want to go home when the library closes. But the best part of all of this is that I convinced Mayor Carpenter in the city to set up a little mini grant program.
Yeah.
So once you go through the training and once you learn how to do this, I also teach you how to fill out a grant application, so there's a little money available at the end to fund your project or to fund your event. So there's a little, there's a little bit of vigorish at the end. So February 7th, if you want to find out more about it, teambrocktonrlp.weebly.com, or go on Facebook to my website, Lynn Smith, and you'll see everything about the program there.
Thank you, Lynn, and thank you for doing what you do. Appreciate
thank you.
It. You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host. Stay tuned for more events, places, people, and faces right here in the City of Champions.